Hello, I'm Daria Fissoun, and in this video, we'll be taking a look at OmniScope's 3D color cube. This Pro version feature allows you to simultaneously monitor the hue, saturation, and luminance values of an image. It's a step up from some of the traditional scopes we use, which are often limited to a two-dimensional readout. To better demonstrate how images are displayed in the 3D color cube, I'll load a hold CLUT pattern, which is an image file featuring every possible pixel value in a given bitrate arranged as gradients in a matrix. By dragging the offset master wheel in DaVinci Resolve, we can observe that pure white is located in one corner of the cube, and pure black in the opposite. Saturation, when reduced, compresses the matrix towards the center of the cube, while still maintaining the diagonal luminance line. When increased, saturation pushes the values against the sides of the cube. Adding color dominance will pull the values of the cube towards that hue. And working in tonal ranges will affect some values of the cube more than others, causing the trace in the cube to warp. The 3D color cube gives us a clearer idea of the distribution of the colors in an image than most 2D scopes. It can show us if there are dominant colors in the shadows or highlights, or if there are elements with stronger saturation relative to the rest of the image. It can help reveal if there is compression artifacting, and can also offer a clue as to whether an image is correctly color managed or not. There's a few ways you can interact with a 3D color cube. Click and drag your mouse to rotate the cube in 3D space. Use your scroll wheel to zoom in and out. And hold Ctrl or Command while scrolling for finer zoom control. Middle or double click to reset the position of the cube. As with the other scopes, you can drag in the source viewer to review a section of the frame. Hold Shift and drag to keep that selection in place for closer trace study. Right-click within the window to reveal the contextual menu. Here, you can change the color space of the scope, usually based on your workflow, application, or media format. Go to Settings for more controls. Clicking Signal Range Override will allow you to display a video range overlay within the data range cube, so you can see if your signal has clipped the legal boundaries. Under Appearance, drag Enhance to adjust the intensity of the trace in the cube. When Enhance is set to 0, the pixels in the cube are rendered using the original RGB values from the picture. By increasing it, you boost the saturation, essentially converting the values from RGB to HSL with increased saturation and luminance components. Point size will affect the size of the particles in the trace. And Render 3D Arrows will display or hide the RGB arrows on the cube axes, giving you an unobstructed view of the trace within. Dragging the zoom slider will accomplish the same thing as scrolling in the window. However, here you can also hold Ctrl or Command and click to enter custom zoom values. Now, let's take a look at a practical example of the 3D color cube in action. At first glance, this image appears to have very clean colors with no distortion of any kind. However, when we look at the trace in the 3D color cube, there appear to be some offshoots in the green, orange, and blue hues. The blue in particular is very aggressively saturated. The trace is actually flattened against the blue side of the cube, which is a sign of oversaturation and possible distortion. Looking back at the image, the actor's skin tones and clothing both look very natural. Isolating the jean jacket in the viewer, I can see that the trace is well within bounds. The distortion is actually coming from the neon signs in the background. You can see the elevated green and orange to the right, as well as the oversaturated blue on the left. Due to its very small size and proximity to the highlights, this distortion is not immediately obvious in the other scopes. We can use a gamut adjustment tool, an HSL curve, or simply key and desaturate those regions to smooth the trace and produce a more harmonious image. I hope you enjoyed this video on the 3D color cube. Please check out the video description for links to the official documentation on this scope in the Time & Pixels website. If you've given this video a like, thank you! And please consider subscribing to the channel to be informed of future scope tutorials and OmniScope product announcements.